child pose for a few breaths. Spread the skin on your back, spread the ribs, invite a bit more breath in. Relax the face, the palms of your hands. And then come up, pressing the hands below the shoulders, the feet flat, look down, relax the neck, and take some free movements around the spine. Push the ribs out to one side and then to the other side. Lower the belly, inhale. Pull the spine up, exhale, look back. Do that a few times, slowly. Why slowly? To bring more awareness in the sensation of the torso expanding, the spine lengthening. Your hands and feet pressing against the earth. Exhaling to pull the belly in. Feel all those different elements. Then bring the right hand below the face and take the left arm up towards the sky or the ceiling. Press against the earth and reach higher. On the exhale, thread the left arm under the right as far as you can. Spread the fingers, bring the hands down on the floor, on the grass or the floorboard. And take the right arm up. When you lift your arm, be aware of what your shoulder is doing. Do not leave the shoulder close to the jaw, but take it away from the jaw. And bind across the back. Maybe you can reach out to the left thigh, keep opening the shoulder. Take two or three breaths, deep and easy. And then with your right hand, catch your right ankle. Press the left hand against the floor, the ground, and pull your right ankle towards the sky. So the knee comes off the floor and you lift your thigh as hard as you can. Breathe, press the left hand down, lift the knee as high as you can, flex the right foot, smile, and come down. Come back up to your tabletop position and switch side. Left hand pressing down firmly, right arm moving up. And you thread right under the left. Back of the shoulder, down, cheek down, spread all five fingers. Lift the left arm up, shoulder rolls back. Bind. Breathe from the belly. And then catch the left ankle. Flex the left foot and pull the thigh high above the ground. Breathe. And come down for a few free movements. Again, cat and cow, free movements. When you're ready for your first down dog, come into downward facing dog. For five breaths. Bring some micro movements around the hips. Spread the fingers, press all the knuckles down. Press the hands down and lengthen torso towards the back. Breathe in to expand ribcage sideways. And breathe out to push the hips back, tailbone up. Breath in through the nose,
breath out through the nose. Two more breaths. Shoulder blades rolling out slightly. Bend the legs, everyone, a little. Breathe in, expand sideways, and breathe out to push the hips back. And slowly walk towards the front of the mat. Come into ragdoll. Feet wide apart. Bend the legs a lot. Lengthen torso forward and fall forward freely in that wide space open between the thighs. Catch the elbows. Look back, keep the neck relaxed. Relax the jaw, the whole face, and gently swing from hips down, from side to side, with no muscular effort to pull the torso on one side. Let the weight of the upper body gently guide the movement and feel it. What does this movement create? A sensation in the legs, at the back of the legs, around the neck and shoulders. And come out, bring the feet together, bend the legs slightly, fingertips down close to the toes, and you lengthen the chest forward. You push the pubic bone back, breathe in. Exhale to fold. Take your time to unfold, come up straight, tall as you can. Then press your feet, spread them against the ground and bring both hands to your heart. And close your eyes for a moment. Before we start flowing, let's set an intention for today or for life. Send both arms up towards the sky. Inhale. Bring the quality of your intention back to your heart. Then relax shoulders, come into Tadasana for a moment. Just to feel your grounding, your balance, your center. Spread the palms of your hands and your feet. Bring the tailbone slightly down. Always when we stand up, we want to bring the tailbone down. Why? To decompress, to keep the lower back uncompressed. Breathe in deeply. And empty out fully, open your mouth. Now let's do some sand salutation. We're going to do two rounds of sand salutation. A, two rounds of sand salutation. B, and two rounds of traditional. Maybe with a twist or two. So stand up at the front of your mat, feet together. Inhale to rise up. Exhale to fold. Flat back, inhale. Press the hands, step or jump back, come into a plank, take a breath in, press the hands away from the chest, exhale to lower chest and body, inhale into cobra, gentle back bend, and exhale to down dog. Breathe in through the nose, breathe out through the nose, bend both legs, step forward, long flat back, inhale. Press the hands, exhale. Rise up, breathe in. Lift the ribs high. Hands to the ground, exhale. Halfway up, elongate, breathe in. Exhale down. High to low plank. Breathing into cobra with arm bends if you want before upward facing dog. Down dog, exhale. Press the knuckles down, breathe in. Breathe out through the nose. Bend both legs, step forward. We've done two rounds, right? Elongate, inhale. Exhale to fold. Chair pose. To start sun salutation, be sit low. Press the feet down. Elongate, torso up. Arms straight, activate fingers. Shoulders down. Relax the jaw. And fold forward. Flat back, pubic bone back, chest bone forward, inhale. fold forward, exhale. Vinyasa high to low plank. Maybe now you come into upward facing dog. Press the hands, send shoulder blades back, bring tailbone down. Exhale, down dog, belly coming in. Inhale through the nose. Exhale through the nose, right leg up. Breathe in, elongate the whole body. Bend the leg, open the right side. Knee to chest, exhale. Inhale, lengthen up. Knee to the left armpit. Extend the leg across the mat. Take the left arm up, lift the hips as high as you can. Neck relaxed. Back to a three-legged dog. Take one breath in. Knee to the right elbow. Make connection. Bend the arms, lower the chest. Take three little hops on the back foot. One, two, three. Leg up, inhale. Step forward. Warrior one, one breath. Open warrior two. Flip, front palm, breathe in, reverse exhale. High to low plank with breath. Synchronize breathing. Exhale as you lower yourself. Inhale to up dog, down dog, exhale. One breath in and a full breath out. Open your mouth. Press the hands down, take the left leg up. Bend the leg, open left side. Breathe through the left side. Then bring the knee to the chest, empty the breath. Inhale, lengthen up. Knee to the right armpit. Extend the leg, put the foot down. Right hand high, the hips moving up. Take one breath in, expand, and one breath out, back to down dog. Inhale through the nose. Exhale, bring the knee to the left elbow or tricep. Lower the chest and hop three times. One, two, three. Three-legged dog, inhale. Warrior one, ground yourself and expand, breathe in. Open to warrior two. Flip the front palm, reach forward, inhale. Reverse to peaceful warrior, exhale. Hands to the mat, high plank. Low plank to breathe out. Up dog or cobra, downward facing dog to elongate the spine. Press the hands down. Bend the legs, lower the knees, few inches off the ground. Breathe in to send the ribs out to the side. Breathe out to send the hips back and the heels down. Again, breathe in through the nose. Bend the legs slightly. Breathe out fully if you want. Belly coming in. Bend both legs, look forward. Jump to the front of the mat. Long flat back, inhale. Exhale to fold. Chair pose, sit as low as you can, one breath. Fold forward, exhale. Halfway lift, open the chest wide, inhale. Fold forward, exhale. Downward facing dog, or vinyasa. Breath in through the nose. Breath out through the nose. Right foot steps forward, warrior one. Open to warrior two. Stay in warrior two for a moment. Lengthen the spine up. Bring shoulders down. Activate 10 fingers. Relax the jaw. Now open your palms to face up. Notice how all the joints in your arms start to rotate externally. Elbows, shoulders, lifting the heart up. Inhale. Keep rotating arms out. Exhale to rotate internally. Curve the spine down. Empty the breath, empty the belly. Inhale, again. Extend the rotation of the arms, elbows, shoulders. Look up towards the sky, breathe in. Internal rotation of the arms, breathe out. Back to a neutral warrior two. Flip the front palm, reach forward. Reverse exhale, one breath. Extended side angle, right forearm to the right thigh, left arm reaching forward. Stay in the pose, curl the tailbone down. Lower belly coming in. Inhaling through the nose. Focused, present, grounded. Bring both hands down to the mat. Step back to downward facing dog. Take one breath in through the nose. Exhale fully, sigh out, flutter the lips. Make noise if you want. Then step the left foot forward. Warrior one, one breath, slow. Open to warrior two. Now interlace fingers in the back. Pull the shoulders back and down. And fall forward into humble warrior. Breathing in, relaxing the jaw. Bring your attention to the shoulder blades and feel them moving closer to the spine. Let go of the core, of the hip joints. Let the torso weigh down. Breathe in to lengthen torso down. Breathe out to take your hands further away from the spine. And then slowly come back to warrior two. Flip the front palm, elongate, inhale, reverse, exhale. To take one breath in through the nose and one breath out, to wheel the hands forward, coming into your extended side angle. Breathing in through the nose. Exhale softly through the nose. Bring both hands down. Step back to your plank. High plank, low plank, exhale. Upward facing dog. Stay in up dog for a moment. Press the feet flat. Lengthen tailbone down. Then stretch the abdominal column towards the sky. Lift your heart and send the shoulder blades behind your heart as much as you can. Breathe in. Breathe out over the right shoulder. Breathe in up towards the center. Out over the left shoulder. Breath in. Downward facing dog, breath out. Take the right leg up. Bend open. Bring the foot down, take the left leg up. Bend and open. Bring the foot down, bend both legs. Step or jump forward. Long flat back, inhale. Fold, exhale, chair pose. Come on the ball of the feet. Heels off the ground. Sit a bit lower. Then keep the heels off the ground and go as tall as you can. And then lower the heels down, lower your hands by your side. Let's come back to Tadasana for a moment. Relax shoulders down. Rotate your head a few times if you want, gently. Then spread the feet. Drop your weight towards the earth. I'm talking about the physical weight, but maybe the mental weight as well. Spread the palms of your hands. Close your eyes gently. Relax the jaw and the tongue. Feel your rib cage expanding softly as you inhale. Coming down as you exhale with the belly coming in slightly. Now let's do one round of traditional sun salutation. Bring the feet together. Rise up, inhale. Lower hands to your heart to exhale. Shoulders relaxed. Bend the legs slightly, bring tailbone under and reach high, breathe in. Activate fingers. Lift the ribs high, lower hands to the floor, exhale. Flat back to breathe in. Exhale to press the palms. Step the left foot back. Lower the hips. You can bring the left knee all the way down if you want. Or bend the leg slightly. Keep the hips low and take both arms up. High. Lower ribs stay in as much as possible. Lengthen through the back, through the whole rib cage. And then come into your vinyasa, high to low plank, with the knees down if you want. Up dog, inhale. Down dog, exhale. Left foot steps between the hands. Both arms up, one breath. Step up the front to fold. Unfold slowly. Breathe in, sweep palms up. Hands to your heart. Exhale. Lengthen up. Invite the breath in. Hands to the floor. Breathe out. Long flat back. Inhale. Fold forward. Exhale. Right foot back. Both arms up. Two breaths. Slow. Deep. Powerful. Grounded. Safe. Vinyasa high to low plank. Inhaling into upward facing dog, opening the upper chest. Exhaling into down dog to lengthen the spine up towards the sky. Take a deep breath in. A full breath out if you want. Then step the right foot between your hands. Both arms up, one breath. And then you step up the front to fold. Long flat back, inhale. Fold forward, exhale. Cross the legs and sit down. Then grab the back of the knees and roll back to front a few times. Inhale as you rock back. Exhale as you rock forward. Bring more breath to create more momentum. And at some point, you use that momentum to come forward straight into chair pose. With the lucky ones, we're on the slope, it will help. Chair pose, sit low. Interlace fingers behind the back, pull shoulders back. Then take the feet apart and fall forward. Look back, lengthen your arms. Lengthen your torso, relax your neck and jaw. And release, bring the feet together. Let's come back up. I give you the choice for the twist. Chair twist or lunge twist? Which one? We could do both, but we only have 75 minutes. Lunge twist? Yeah. Chair twist is this. Sit low. Lower the shoulders, lengthen the spine up. Bring the belly in to exhale softly and twist towards the road, towards the right. Left elbow outside of the right thigh, maybe. Maybe you curl the toes up and you breathe. That's not a maybe, that's a must. Now sit as low as you can and bring your hands all the way out to the ground, to the right side. Connect the left elbow to the outside of the right knee and twist more to bring the chest to face the rod. The heart is kept high. And then you press your palms down and you move your chest towards the fingertips. Bend the arms, bend the arms. When you feel your chest above the hands, the feet can come up. Then you keep both legs together and lengthen them forward. And come out, ragdoll, fall forward. Take a deep breath in through the back of the lungs. Open your mouth wide. Let it out. And there is no reason to be shy with the way we breathe. Unless we want to keep the toxicity of whatever doesn't serve us inside. Breathe it out. Deep breath in. Full breath out. Big toe grab. Catch the big toes, bend the legs. Lengthen torso forward, long. As you exhale, lift the sit bones up and bring the shoulders down, wide. Wide shoulders, wide elbows. Look back, relax neck. Breathe in through the sides, along the spine. Breathe out to lift the tailbone, lengthen back of the thighs, pull on the toes. Back to chair pose, feet together. Sit low, elongate torso up, inhale. And through your heart, exhale. Shoulders relax, neck is free all around. Come into your chair twist in your own time, with breath. Take a breath in through the nose, breathing out through the nose to rotate this shoulder for the back and maybe relax neck looking down. Breath in and breath out. Sit lower, bring the hands all the way down to the ground. Press the fingertips down and drive the torso into a deeper twist maybe. Slowly you bend the arms, lengthen chest towards the fingertips. Keep the legs together, engage through the core to keep the legs together light, and then send the legs forward together. Press the hands down, relax to the lightness of the pose, and slowly come out. Both feet hip distance apart or slightly more. Gorilla pose. Bring the whole palm under the feet. Bend the legs, just like the big toe grab, but with the palms under. Send the butt towards the back, chest forward, inhale. Exhale, relax neck, look back, lift the sit bones up. Relax the jaw, if necessary. If you're not sure, just do it. And come out, feet together, long flat back, inhale. Fold, exhale, jump back, high plank, lower the plank, empty the breath. Come into upward facing dog and down dog, breathe out. Walk on the spot for a few breaths. Feel the body. Check with the grounding, the feet. How do you connect with the ground, casually or mindfully? Choose the latter. Then your hips. How do you feel around the hips? Feel that. And then along the spine, make it long. Take a deep breath in and a full breath out. Bend both legs, look forward, jump to the front of your mat and grab a strap. Strap in one hand. Let's take the right knee up as high as we can. As we exhale, we push the ball of the foot forward, spreading the toes. Inhale, knee up. Exhale, push. Knee up. Now, either you use the strap around the foot or you grab the big toe. You lift the knee and the heart higher, pressing the standing foot against the ground. Soften the gaze. Breathe and elongate the leg forward. Keep shoulders back and down. Open to the right side. Open the left arm out to the left. Now feel your right leg and at the hip joint, rotate externally slightly. Lift your heart more and smile. Bring the knee forward. Do not put the foot down. Warrior three. Push the heel back and take both arms forward. Elongate the whole body. The toes pointing down. You might have to bring an internal rotation in the leg. Breathe. Then lower the hand to the floor. The whole hand flat. Relax neck. Bend the standing leg and hope. Three times or four times or five times, just to make it playful. Little hope. And then you come a bit higher, maybe. Good, child pose. For three breaths, make the most of it. Breathing in deeply and breathing out generously, giving it out, all of it. Take the knees wide, maybe to open the hip joints a bit more. Breath in towards the lower back. Breath out. Ah, and again, in. Downward facing dog. One breath in through the nose. One breath out through the nose. I forgot what we did before on the other side. Step to the front of your mat, long flat back, inhale. Exhale to fold and slowly rise up. Press both feet down, then shift your weight on the right foot, take the left knee high. Use the strap if you want or not, just like you did on the other side. On the exhale, push the ball of the foot forward. Inhale, lift the knee high. Exhale, lengthen back of the leg. Breath in, lift the knee up. Grab the big toe. Keep the knee close to the center of the body, not out to the side. Lengthen leg forward. And open. Rotate the leg externally. Lift the heart more. Warrior three, without putting the foot down. Push the heel as far back as you can and send the ribs forward. Activate fingers, relax the face. Then bring the hands down flat, press the hands, arms straight, bend the standing leg, and hop 3, 4, 5 times. Bring the belly in slightly. One more time. Child pose. Send the hips back. Lengthen torso and let the weight go down. Breathing in through the nose and breathing out. Inhaling, exhaling. In your own time, come back to downward facing dog. Take the left leg up. Bend open. Come to a flip dog or wild thing. Maybe the right leg straight, or you bend both legs. If you bend both legs, keep both heels down. Whatever you choose, send the spine up towards the sky. Open the front side, breathe in. Lift the hips high as you can. Press the hands down. Breath. And come back to down dog with one leg up. The left leg stays up. Take a breath in and step forward into pigeon pose. Take the left knee out, way out. Any knee problem, Emma? No? Knee out. Pelvic floor down, right foot moves back slightly. You can keep the torso high above the ground. Notice how is the breathing. How is the thinking? Come back to observe the breath. How does it feel between the ribs, in your back? Relax the jaw. And then elongate torso forward. To bring it down slowly. If it helps to support the forehead with a block, do so. Or maybe to support the left side. If you can, take your left knee a little bit further out, Thandi. That's okay. Just make sure the breath stays comfortable, guys. Because we're going to stay in that pose for a little while. Let's not make it a fight. It's more costly in terms of energy than to accept and go with the flow. Right now, the flow is the flow of your breath. Just relate to that. Breath alongside the spine towards the lower back. Feed the sacrum, the hips area. This posture is activating, energizing your first and second energy center, root chakra, sacral chakra. Listen to the sounds around you. Smell the ground, the earth, if you're outside. And if you need to take one or two deep, releasing breaths out, don't wait to be told. Do what feels good. Let's take a few more breaths here. Elongate your arms forward just a little and move them out to the right side. From the hips, not just from the shoulders. The whole torso moves out. Feel the left hip joints, the left side opening slowly. That space between the hip and the lower rib. Let it soften for two more breaths. And come back to down dog. To take the right leg up, to bend and open and come into flip dog. Back to a three-legged dog, long body, breathe in, step forward, pigeon, right knee out. Make your little adjustments. To be open, to feel something. It shouldn't feel comfortable. If it's too comfortable, it means that you stay in your comfort zone of yesterday. Expand it a little. Breathe in softly. Breathe out to lower belly and ribs down. And we stay here for 3 minutes. If you can, elongate both arms forward. Let the armpits come a bit closer to the ground. And if it triggers some resistance to the pose, just notice, where is the resistance playing? Usually it starts between the ears, that's for sure. But then what part of the body reacts to that and stay a little bit tense? See if you can speak to your body in very loving terms. Make it feel safe and slowly decontract, relax those areas one at a time. Relax the face. Relax your ears or your ears. Feel the ground beneath supporting you. You can let go of everything right now and just focus on your breath. One more minute. Maybe the breath slows down a little. And maybe the torso opens towards the left a little with the arms lengthening. Maybe by 1 centimeter. Take 3 more breaths to let go of any remaining resistance to the pose. See how it feels when you stop fighting. Slowly come up. Come up with both legs forward. Bring your hands just behind you. Lift your heart. Check the legs a little. And then bring the knees up. Connects your belly ribs to the thighs. So the knees can come all the way up. If you want, use your strap to send it around both feet, or you catch the sides of the feet. Do not grab the toes. If you use the strap, put it quite low towards the heels. Then lengthen torso up. Stay connected to the thighs as much as you can. Breathe in, and as you breathe out, start to send the heels forward, but keep the torso long, do not bend. So you don't have to stretch the legs fully. Feel the lower back. Take a breath in, elongate the torso, breathe out, push the heels forward. And one breath at a time, see how long you can make that spine. Keeping face relaxed and breath soft. And maybe you catch the feet. Try not to send the shoulders too close to the ears. Stay spacious around the ears and the neck. Breath in to move the ribs slightly forward. And breath out to soften into that pose. Spread the toes, push the ball of the feet forward. Inhale, lengthen torso. Just a little. Exhale, soften shoulders and face. Stay in the pose. Maybe you find the edge of your comfort zone. Just stay there for a few breaths. Do not retreat. Do not venture too far in the wild. That's an ego thing. Just acknowledge where you are. Acknowledge the breath. The sensations. Take two more breaths. And slowly come out. Come on your back. Hands on the knees. Open the knees and rotate around the sacrum a few times. Then take both legs up. Curl the toes down. Inhale. Exhale to push the toes up towards the sky. Keep the head on the floor, relax the neck, shoulder blades wide and flat. Now bring your hands flat. Take a breath in. And as you breathe out, lift the sacrum off the floor, send the legs up towards the ceiling, trying not to jump too much, just elevate the legs up. One, two, three, four, breathing down, exhale, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Bring the feet down. Lengthen both legs forward. Keep them off the floor by a few inches. And bring the shoulder blades off the ground, chin to the chest. Send both arms forward, as far forward as you can, activate fingers. Bring the right knee to the chest, as close to the chin, as to the face as you can. Keep lengthening the left leg and both arms. Belly comes down. One, two, three. Breathe. Four, five. Exhale to lower the belly. Six. Keep pulling in both directions. Seven, eight, nine, 10. Switch side. Do not put the foot down yet. One, two, spread the toes. Three, spread the fingers. Four, five, six, breath. Feel the fire, breathe. Eight, nine, 10. Come down, take a full body stretch. Sigh out. Wiggle the hips around a few times. Let's come into a gentle back bend. Let's do a camel. Roll your mat under the kneecaps. Keep the heels off the ground, or you can bring the feet flat, up to you. Now, thumbs on the sacrum. Push the sacrum down, tailbone down, breathe in. Lift the ribs, lift your heart. As you breathe out, no back bending yet, just rotate shoulders back. Notice the length of the spine as you inhale. Find more range in length. And as you exhale, keep pushing tailbone down and send the upper spine further back. Take your time. Breathe in, elongate, lift your heart, open the heart space. Press sacrum down, find the comfort in the lower back created by this pressuring down. And come out slowly. Find a neutral vertical pose here. Hips above the knees, shoulders above the hips. Breathe in, expand. Breathe out, soften shoulders. Let's go back. Maybe this time you come a little bit deeper. In your own time, I'm not counting, you choose. If you want to go and grab your ankles, do so. Keep pushing the hips forward. Take five breaths here. Inhaling to lift the heart high. And keep pushing the hips forward. Breath in. And release, come forward. Let's come into a puppy pose. That's a nice counter pose to bring freedom in the lower back. So what we do, hips above the knees, arms moving forward, extend the torso forward, and let the spine just fall down like a chain hanging from the lower back above the floor, the ground. Open the space between upper ribs and armpits, between the hip bones and the lower ribs. Breathe. Send the hips a little bit further forward, Thandi. Keep the hips above the knees. At the moment, your hips are far, the knees are here, your hips are here. You want to move the hips to be in line with the knees. Breathe. And slowly come out.
Two breaths in Shavasana. So let the legs roll out. Connect the sacrum down to the earth. And feel each vertebra that is in contact with the ground. How does it feel in that particular place? Feel the space between the vertebra. The space between the shoulder blades. Relax your neck as much as you can. Take a deep breath in. Sigh out. Now bring the right knee towards your face. Interlace your hands behind the right thigh. Lengthen the back of the thigh to bring the knee closer to your face. Keep the head down. And bring the lower leg vertical. The sole of the foot facing up. Drive the right arm inside of the right thigh. Catch the outside of the foot and slowly drive the knee down towards the armpit, towards the shoulder, towards the ground. Curl the toes down. Lengthen the left leg. Bring your left hand to gently press on the left hip to keep it down, to keep the pelvis stable. Catch the big toe with one finger, out of two fingers, and lengthen the leg up. Breathe in. As you breathe out, open the leg out to the right. Keep pulling on the big toe. Breathe. Hold it. Embrace it. You feel some intensity? Embrace it. Embrace the experience. Bring more breath into it and slowly come out. Switch side. Lengthen the right leg. Bring the left
knee close to the face. Shin bone vertical. Drive your arm in. Catch the outside of the foot or the heel and gently bring it down. Letting the right leg, right hand on the right hip.
If you're outside, look up, look at the face of the clouds. Make your breath match that movement of your head. Feel the body supported by the ground and lengthen the leg up towards the sky, pulling the big toe down.
And then open the leg out to the left. And come out.
Grab a block for a supported fish. Flat, long, narrow side up. And bring the space between your shoulder blades on the block. Keep the neck free. And the mid spine free.
You can lengthen both legs forward or bring them into butterfly, which is my favorite. Curl the toes out. The Let the shoulders roll out. Let the energy of the sun flood your heart space, your solar plexus, your throat. Liberate your speech, your free speaking, your heart. The way you project yourself out to the world, the sensations you have around the solar plexus, make that free. Breathe in the energy of life, more. Breathe out whatever toxicity has been weighing down on you for the last few days, months, years. Give it to the earth. Breath in slowly. Let the breath spread through all the most remote parts of your body and mind. When you're ready for Shavasana, roll on the side, remove the block, and come into Shavasana.
Start to deepen your breath and move fingers, toes, roll your head slowly from side to side. The arms over your head, take a full body stretch. Big sigh out if you want, and then bring the knees towards the chest. Tuck the knees in as tight as you can. Roll towards the right hand side. Then slowly come up to sit up straight and tall, rounded. Hands to your heart, breathe in deeply. Breathe out, fully relax shoulders down. We bow forward to acknowledge ourselves and everybody present here.